all his books, all his publications, he published with Karl Marx. So there is the question, where does this Karl Heinrich Marx comes from? Marx, as every person, is formed by his environment. He receives certain influences, then he reacts to these influences. This also will bring out further contacts with other persons, further influences, and so on. And this process starts rather early. In the case of Marx, we have also the problem that about his early years, for example, in school time, we have nearly no information. But Marx, when he finished school, he was already a formed person. So we have to look what kind of school it was, what were the teachers, what do they think. In some respect, we have to look like an archaeologist to see certain fragments, to interpret the fragments, to construct something which can give us an answer. Then we come to his time of study in the universities of Bonn and Berlin, and again we have even less information. We don't know all his friends in this time. From letters we have some names, and we have really not more than the names. We not even know what these persons done, but also they had an influence. And then the first document, big document we have, is the PhD thesis of Marx. But in this thesis, Marx already has elements of an original thinker. And in order to learn how this original thinker in process was produced, we must, like an archaeologist, collect all the informations. And I think in biographies already existing, this was not done. It was taken a lot of things for granted, the relation to his parents, or in many biographies you can read in school time he had no friends. This is wrong. I found several persons where I can say it's rather probable that he had friendly relations with them. And so in order to do this job, it needed a certain depth and a certain extension of research, what then led to this first volume. Okay, we know Karl Marx, and sometimes some persons come and say Karl Heinrich Marx, presuming that, oh, you not even know the full name, but I know it, it is Karl Heinrich Marx. Also this I investigated, and there is not really a document. The birth certificate of Karl Marx is Karl Marx, no Heinrich. The certificate of his marriage is Karl Marx. The treaty about the marriage he had with Jenny is Karl Marx. All his books, all his publications, he published with Karl Marx. So there is the question, where does this Karl Heinrich Marx comes from? I think the main source is Friedrich Engels, who wrote in the early 1890s, I think it was 92, 93, he wrote an entry in an encyclopedia, Marx, Heinrich Karl. And then he gave some basic questions. Also, Franz Mehring, the first serious biographer of Marx, used this information from Engels, calling him not Heinrich Karl, but Karl Heinrich Marx. And now comes into play, and this information given by Engels and by Franz Mehring was copied a lot by biographers and writers about Marx. And now the only point where Marx used this Karl Heinrich was when he inscribed in the university in Bonn and later in Berlin, where he had to present the papers from Bonn, and there we found already the Heinrich. And because he had to present his exams when he wanted to do his PhD, so on the title page of the non-published PhD thesis, we also find the Karl Heinrich Marx. But these are the only sources. Marx then never used this Heinrich. And I suppose he did this when he went to Bonn. He was 17 years old, starting university. He used this Heinrich because in this time he wanted to become a writer. He wrote poems, and the Karl Marx sounds so poor, so simple, so not poetry-like, that he chose the name of his the first name of his father and named himself Karl Heinrich Marx, which for a German poet would sound much more nice. But later, when he didn't want to become a poem any longer, he restricted to his Karl Marx, and I think this is formally his real name and the name he used all the time of his life beyond these inscriptions in university.